Outlaw, taking it off. Do not own the rights to this music. It's being played in a track. It's like 16 cars.
One more time around here. Race outlaws for 35 laps for 35 minutes. Mark did it.
Yeah, they took the cone out.
You have one shot.
A lot of tracks, that'd be a penalty.
So 66 of Rule will be dropping to the back.
See?
Wow. What a
bad. Oh, it is a penalty.
For the first time, this division doesn't change the rule. He hits the cone. That's a no-no. You got to go to the tail to do that. That's what's going to happen. He was a strong competitor.
I've seen cars stop on the end of the cone, you know what I mean? Because they knew they were fixing to hit it, you know?
The outside of the third row, the fastball, the wire is going to restart on the outside of the front row. That'd be Timothy Watson, 28.
He gets out front, he got it.
What happened there? I think Rudel expected the leader, Winslow, to go to the outside, and he went to the inside. I think he was changing his mind in the last second when he did. It was too late. He hit the cone.
It was complicated by the fact that the time before that,
leave it on just to see if they're going to hit the cone.
Cone is on the front stretch. Let's see if all the drivers are able to successfully...
You said they picked a good support class this time where they got out of the car.
Yeah.
Do a better job this time, but they come by here. Look at Timothy Watson's left foot.
Boy, Rube about to drop the wall. You need to wait that cone.
Spot on the outside of row two, so he chooses the lane that others were.
picks up two spots, but can he hang on to him from outside of run number two?
Just because of that shoes rule, Pato gains two spots for where he's running, but he's going to restart. One go of line.
Outside, fourth row. beside you, Bubba. Come on, man. Come on, Bubba. Drive that thing. Anybody else losing to that? activity. 42 is moving quick.
In this Faith Chapel Outlaw 35 live feature event. What a run for Cameron Henderson in the 792. Started this race inside of row number 5. Missed the other by a few spots with a candid bottom. When he gets it done in the race, he's got one of the cleanest cars, about runs over Stan down there on the front stretch. As he will celebrate on the front straightaway. In victory lane, good run for second place, Connor Sutton. Third place, the 28th time of the Bronson, despite the body damage on the left front. As we get ready to send it down to Bill Roth, who will have a word on our time
repeat. A well-deserved victory here for this gentleman from Logan. On strap. We will talk to the ring, Cameron Henderson, in just a moment.
But the two ugliest ones are second.
Unstrapped and out of the car with the checkered flag. How about it for Cameron Henderson? Dothan, Alabama driver with a big, big checkered flag. Come on out here, Cameron.
But for cheap metal wise, there's only one or two.
Every time we see you, you're fast, but this checkered flag comes on a big stage. Congratulations.
Yeah, you got to catch one good.
28 got a little hot.
Car was just making so fast. I got to give it up to you guys. We've been working on it from the time we got here to the race.
Nobody knows why except you and your crew why this is 792. I think it's a combination of two different efforts, right?
Yeah, I'm 7, Jerry's 92, so we just put 792 on it. I was actually going to take it off this race because I thought it was bad luck, but now I have to leave it on there.
You better leave it on there. Cameron Henderson, Faith Chapel Outlaw winner.
I want to thank Mr. Gary Bradford. Mr. Green, they own the car. They just let me drive it. I'm really blessed to be able to do that. And James at Eurotech Performance Engines. Oh, man, this thing was a hot ride.
Okay. Somebody's got to turn that steering wheel, and that's you. Cameron Henderson gets the win, 792. It seems every time I talk to this driver, it's a second place finish. Connor Sutton. A little damage there, but it was a pretty good run.
It was a good night. I can't thank the guys enough. I really shouldn't even be here today. I got a call this morning to go back to work, and I was asleep when they called. So I can't thank my grandpa enough for just letting me stay home and come race. I wish he was here for this. And looking forward to when we get back in town. It'll be late in the summer, but I think we got a good piece for the show.
He was second in the point standings last year. Take it from me, Connor. Checkered flag in your future in this division. Nice run. I don't know if we're going to be able to talk to Timothy Watson or not. He probably took off for his late models. He's still here. He is. So, did you want that car to fly or what with the body damage on the left front?
Man, Tim, the body ended up like that, but it was really fast until I couldn't see anything and I kept missing my marks. But we'll get it put back together and put back up for next time. Hopefully, do a little better.
I told everybody on the PA system, for my few years of driving race cars, that left front is pretty much where you're looking all the time, and you had a great big old fender in your view.
Yeah, normally I try and put your left side down on that yellow line, and I couldn't see the yellow line, so that hurt me a little bit. And then the car started getting really loose, so we had some work to do with it.
You think that thing blowing up like that hurt your performance a little bit?
Well, I'd like to say it did, because I ended up third, but I'm not really sure how much it really hurt me speed-wise, other than I couldn't see.
We're going to get to that super late model, get a third in that race. Timothy Watson from Panama City, third, Outlaw 28.